Noon, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'm glad as usual to greet you in the matchless and powerful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Happy September to everyone. Today is September 1. Thank God for bringing us safely through the month of August. And here we are in a brand new month, a brand new day, and another chance to give God thanks, praise, honor, and glory. So won't you please come on as I make some notices and announcements. Please be reminded that we have Bible study tonight. Please meet me at 7 o'clock for Bible study. We know the grass withers and the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. So I'll be looking for you. Then on this Friday, we will have, as we partner with the 7th Precinct Interfaith Clergy Council, with the organization called DRUM, and with some young men who just wanted to give back to the community, we will have a school supply backpack drive on this Friday from 11 to 2. Please, as we try to encourage our children, pray for them, but also arm them with some of the materials that they need. So please meet us here. We'll be giving out free school supplies and backpacks as our children prepare to go to school. And then finally, let me encourage you, if you have not already done so, to get vaccinated. If your child is over 12, then they are eligible for the vaccine. We know that this vaccine helps to retard or to stop the spread of this virus. We know that it will help to keep your children safe, and we know that it'll help to keep you safe. We know that the persons that are in hospital right now with the COVID are those persons who have refused to get the vaccine. Let's exercise wisdom. Somebody said, well, where is your faith? Listen, God is omniscient. That's one of the characteristics and attributes of God, that God is omniscient. God knows everything. So God already had the answer to this COVID-19 virus. God already knew that we would find ourselves in this place. And in God's own time, he revealed the solution to the scientists. And so we just have to have enough wisdom to walk in the way of, safety, and to use just common sense. This is not a situation about race. I mean, yes, what the COVID-19 did was that it just magnified the disparities that were always there. We were always depressed, repressed, oppressed, suppressed. There was always racism. The needs in our community were always greater and continue to be. And so the vaccine will not solve those problems, but it certainly will help us to stay safe. So I want to encourage you to do that. All right, let's move hastily to the word. We're in 2 Peter. Yesterday we completed chapter 2, and it is the Apostle Peter that teaches us how to deal with false teachings, how to negotiate in the time of storm, how the church can be the church. And there are only 3 chapters in Peter's letter to the church. And this is the letter to the early church. And the early church is very much like our church. People are people. You can get new technology. You can get more education. But the needs of people continue to be the same. Human nature continues to be the same. And so this word speaks to us today as loudly as it did when the Apostle Peter wrote these words. Yesterday, we talked about the fact that it's good to remind people about the blessings of God. And Peter says that I want to remind you about the things of God, about God's word. He says, while I have the opportunity, because I know that I'm only in this tent, in this body, for a temporary time. He says, I think it is right to refresh your memory as long as I live in the tent body, because I know that I will soon put it aside, as our Lord Jesus Christ has made clear to me. In other words, one of these days, I'm going to be called out of this mortal body into mortality. I'll be called out of the finite into the infinite. I'll be called out of the present into eternality. And he reminds us that Jesus is real and that the word of God is real, that the prophets did not make it up, but they simply were dictating what was given to them by the Holy Spirit. Let's move now to chapter 2 quite rapidly, because we're going to finish this letter this week. This is so very, very important. Here, the Apostle Peter reminds us to beware of false teachers and false teaching. It is so true today. He says in chapter 2, commencing with verse 1, but there were also false prophets among the people, just as there will be false teachers among you. They will secretly introduce destructive heresies, even denying the sovereign Lord who brought them, bringing swift destruction on themselves. In other words, they will distort the truth. Heresies has to do with giving information that is contrary to the doctrine of the church. And they will mix truth with lies, and so that you will be confused. Just like people will say, well, you can take the vaccine and still get the virus. Yes, nothing is 100% true. That is true. But we do know that it helps to retard the spreading of the virus. You know, God does not move all of our problems, but he will give you the strength to overcome the problem. Many will follow their depraved conduct and will bring the way of truth into disrepute. That you'll follow, people are following wrong and false teachings today. There's still people who believe that Donald Trump is going to be president and that President Biden is not the rightfully elected, duly elected president of these yet to be United States. He says, in their greed, these teachers will exploit you with fabricated stories. Their condemnation has been hanging over them, and their destruction has not been sleeping. In other words, don't worry. God is going to work it out. But in their greed, they exploit the truth and the word of God. There are preachers who want to have you believe that, you know, you just come to Jesus and everything will be fine. Name it and claim it. The Bible never said name it and claim it. It said that if you have faith, you can see those things that are not as if they were. The Bible never said that you would not go through tests and trials and tribulation, that when you came to be a disciple of Christ, that everything would be all right. Jesus says in Matthew 16:33, in the world you will have tribulations, but be of good cheer, I've overcome the world. Let's move on rapidly now. Then you need to know that God will bring justice to the ungodly. God will work it out. Peter tells us here, I'm in verse 4, he says, for if God did not spare angels when they sinned, but sent them to hell, putting them in chains of darkness to be held for judgment, if he did not spare the ancient world when he brought the flood on its ungodly people, but protected Noah, a preacher of righteousness, and seven others, if he condemned the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah by burning them to ashes and made them an example of what was going to happen to the ungodly, and if he rescued Lot, a righteous man who was distressed by the depraved conduct of the lawless, and how he himself was, Lot was tormented in his righteous soul by the lawless deeds he saw and heard. If this is so, then the Lord knows how to rescue the godly from the trials and to hold the unrighteous for punishment on the day of judgment. This is especially true of those who follow the corrupt desires of the flesh and despise authority. People don't preach like this anymore, but it's in the word that God will work it out, and the soul that sins and does not conform to the word of God, that God will deal with them in God's own time. I close now. He says in verse 10, bold and arrogant, they are not afraid to heap abuse on celestial beings. Yet even angels, although they are stronger and more powerful, do not heap abuse on such beings when bringing judgment on them from the Lord. But these people blaspheme in matters that they do not understand. They talk against a God that they do not understand. But even the angels who have power to destroy them will leave it to God to work it out in God's own way. He says they are like unreasoning animals, creatures of instinct, born only to be caught and destroyed. Like the animals, they too will perish. There will be consequences. Verse 13, and I'm going to pause here. They will be paid back with harm for the harm they have done. Their idea of pleasure is to carouse in broad daylight. They are blots of blemishes, reveling in their pleasures while they feast with you. With eyes full of adultery, they never stop sinning. They seduce the unstable. They are experts in greed and a cursed brood. They have left the straight way and wandered off to follow the way of Balaam, who loved the wages of wickedness. But he was rebuked for his wrongdoing by a donkey, an animal without speech, who spoke with a human voice and restrained the prophet's madness. In other words, God used an ass to bring judgment upon the one who was wicked and would not follow in the ways of God. And so don't worry about it. God is working it out. God is for us. God is with us. And so God will judge the unrighteous. God will judge the unrighteous. Don't worry about it. There will be false teachings and false teachers, but God has given us this word of wisdom today, and God will bring judgment to the ungodly, and there will be consequences. Vengeance is mine, the Apostle Paul reminds us in Romans chapter 12, I will repay, saith the Lord. Let me just stop this. Okay, I apologize. Vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord. God will work it out. I know preachers don't preach like this, but it's in the word of God. And we got to preach the whole counsel of God's word to the end, that when he calls us out of darkness into marvelous light, we might hear him say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. Come on up high and I'll make you ruler over many. So I challenge you to continue to read this epistle of Peter, 2 Peter. It's only 3 chapters. Tomorrow, we will dive into chapter 3, and by Friday, we'll conclude chapter 3, and we will have gotten through 1st and 2nd Peter, two epistles where the early apostles warns us of the very thing that we're seeing today. Give God praise, honor, and glory. Let me go ahead and greet some of you now. I'm always so delighted to see you. I thank you for this time together, just to spend a moment with you. How are you, Maxine? Iris, how are you? Wanda, how are you? Sister Marva Harding Clark, how are you? I wrote you a letter just to thank you for your gift. This young lady gave us a gift just for our Bible study. She says how she's being blessed, and Jordan gave a wonderful gift for her birthday. How are you, Valerie? Good to see you. Mary Joseph, good to see you. Virginia Chayner. Jacqueline Wallace, how are you? Brenda Lee, that's my sister. Good to see you. Minister Ellis, good to see you. Phyllis Laria, how are you? Imogene Brown, we continue to pray for you. Sister Shirley Millard, good to see you. Patricia Franklin, how are you? I'm still going to try to reach out to you. Good to see all of you. Thank you for spending this time with me. Know the grass withereth and the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear God, for this time together, we give you thanks for your word that's so pregnant with truth and power that it gives birth while we yet try to understand it. Oh God, we thank you for the Apostle Peter, who reminds us that there will be false teachings and that people will try to take us away from the things of God. But help us to hide your word in our heart that we might not sin. Oh God, bless each person in the sound of my voice. You know every need, every concern. You know the anxiety that is ours in this season, how we need you. Every day and every hour we need you. Oh God, meet each person at the point of their need. Where there's depression, oh God, be our joy. Where there's lack, oh God, be a provider. Where there's sickness, oh God, be Jehovah Rapha, the God that heals. We love you, oh God, and we praise you and we honor you and we give you glory. Thank you for allowing us to just share together in your word. Bind us together now with cords of love that cannot be broken. Hear our prayer now, incline your ear to us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Let's receive the benediction. I'm trying to get you out in no more than 15 minutes. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance and grant you his peace and his love. And you're going in and you're going out and you're down sitting and you're rising till we shall stand in his presence through Jesus the Christ, to whom be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Amen. I'll see you tomorrow as we negotiate the third chapter and the last chapter of 2 Peter. See you tonight at Bible study at 7 o'clock. Bye-bye.